series. And now I want to give you an introductory talk for this chapter number 8, 9, 10, 11. Right? So all of you, 100% attention now required, right? As I discuss with you this chapter number 8, 9, 10 and 11. Okay, these standards which have been issued by ICAI are called as the Engagement and Quality Control Standards, right? Engagement and Quality Control Standards. As a CA, as a practitioner, as a practicing chartered accountant, what are the types of engagement that I can perform? Well, it says you can do an audit engagement, or it says CA, you can do a review engagement, right? Audit and review, both are postmortem activities. Both are performed for the historical financial information, right? Historical financial information. Or CA, you could be appointed for an assurance engagement other than audit or review. You're not told to do audit, you're not told to do review, but you are appointed for some other assurance engagement. Right? Or they are telling CA, don't do audit, don't do review, don't do any assurance work. You need to perform certain related services. And a CA, you need to perform certain related services. Right, so these are the four types of engagement. What are the four types of engagement? Audit engagement, review engagement, assurance engagement other than audit or review, and then you have the related services engagement. Okay, and whatever be the type of engagement that you are performing, okay, you are doing audit or you are doing review or you are doing other assurance engagement or you are doing the related services, it's the quality always has to be maintained. You always need to have the quality in your work done. Okay, so for quality, we have one standard, that is SQC, right? Standard on Quality Control 1, right? Which is the mother standard. Okay, whatever be the type of engagement that you are performing, you always have to maintain the quality. You cannot say, oh, I'm doing related services, no need of quality. No, no. Quality always. Whether doing audit, whether doing review, whether doing other assurance or the related services engagement. Okay, now when you're doing an audit, it says CA, you need to follow the standards on auditing. It says CA, when you're doing review, you need to follow the standards on review engagement. When you're doing the assurance engagement other than audit or review, it says CA, you need to follow the standards on the assurance engagement. And CA, when you're doing the related services, you need to follow the standard on related services. Right? Standard on related services. Right? How many standards on auditing have been issued? 38. Review standards, 2. Other assurance, 3. Related services, 2. And then quality control, 1. Right? So 38, 40, 43, 45 and 46. Right? That's the breakup of the 46 standards. Right, out of these 38 standards, we have 3 standards which are there in the 800 series. Right, we have 3 standards in the 800 series. That is SA 800, yes, SA 800, SA 805 and SA 810, right, which is there in your chapter number 8. Right, then you have the standards on the review engagement, in which you have the SRE 2400 and the SRE 2410, which is there in your chapter number 10. Then you have the standards on assurance engagement, SAE 3400, 3402 and 3420, which is there in chapter number 11. And then standards on related services, SRS 4400 and 4410, which is there in chapter number 9. Right, which is there in the chapter number 9. Okay, right. So first what we need to discuss is discuss these 3 standards of the 800 series. Then look into the review engagement, then assurance engagement, and then also the related services. Right. So right now, to begin with, I am going to discuss with you the 800 series. Everyone, are you with me? Chapter 8, in which we discuss the 800 series, 800, 805 and 810. Right. SA 800, the first one over there. What is the title? It's the special considerations. Special considerations. Audit of financial statements prepared in accordance with special purpose framework. That means now the financial statements which are being audited by auditor have not been prepared by management as per a general purpose framework, but they have been prepared as per a special purpose framework. You know, the financial statements have been prepared for the creditor, or they have been prepared as per the requirement of a contract, or as per the requirement of a regulator, or as per the requirement of the banker, you know, or as per the requirement of the government. That means for a specific set of users. It is not for a wide range of common users. If it is for the, you know, aam janta, it's for everybody, then it is general purpose framework. But this is for a specific set of users. So that comes under the SA 800. Okay. Now, generally, as an auditor, you are appointed to audit the entire financial statements, balance sheet, profit and loss, cash flow, SOCE, and the notes. But now client is telling CA, don't do audit of entire financial statements. We want you to do the audit of a single financial statement, audit of single financial statement. They're saying, see, only audit our balance sheet, only audit our profit and loss account. So single financial statement or specific element, account or item of the financial statement. Specific element, account or item. That means they are saying CA, and like your example, I say they are saying CA only audit balance sheet. Now, specific element account, that means they are telling CA audit only debtor, balance sheet item. But pura balance sheet bhi nahi, usme sirf debtor ka audit karke de do. Ya item, item is related to profit and loss account. So they are saying CA only audit our royalty, only audit our other income. Why they are getting only that audited, that's their call. But they are telling auditor, don't do the audit of the entire financial statements. We want to you to do an audit of the part of the financial statement. What could be that part? It could be a single financial statement, or it could be a specific element, account or item. So rather than every time telling single financial statement, specific element, account or item, I can say audit of a part. Like population sample. So this is an audit of a part of the financial statement. Right, that is SA 805. And then you have the SA 810, which is engagement. Oh my God, they're not using the word audit over here. Hello, yahan pe kya bola tha? Audit of financial statements. Yahan pe kya bola? Audit of single financial statement. Now what they are saying? Engagement to report on summary financial statements, SFS. Hello, what is SFS? Summary financial statement, abridged financial statements, condensed financial statements. Hello, abridged. Hello, the less condensed version of the financial statements. They are telling CA, please report. Engagement to report on summary financial statements. Now, the first point of distinction that you need to know for 800, 805 and 810. Okay, you know, if PwC is doing the audit of the financial statements as per general purpose framework, special purpose framework, can it be audited by PwC? Yes. Can it be audited, say, by KPMG, another CA firm? Yes. So it could be the same auditor or it could be a different auditor for 800. Same thing for SA 805. You know, audit financial statements are being audited by PwC, but audit of the part of the financial statements could be done by PwC or it could be done by KPMG. So again, here it could be the same auditor or it could be a different auditor. Okay, pure financial statements PwC audited and part PwC audited or KPMG audited. Will it be better if PwC only audits? Yes. But can it also be audited by KPMG? Yes. So 800, 805, it may or may not be the same auditor who has done the audit of the audited financial statements. But for SA 810, only the auditor who has given the audit report on the audited financial statements, only that uncle, only that auditor can issue the report on the summary financial statements. So here it has to be the same uncle. it has to be the same auditor. Whereas 800, 805, it may or may not be the same. Whereas 810, it has to be the same auditor. You understand, everyone? Okay, right. Then after that, for SA 800 also, what we need to check? Again, we need to check the acceptability of the AFRF. Here also for 805, we have to check the acceptability of the AFRF. But for 810, okay, now understand, 810 kya hai? Ki these are the audited financial statements. And now you don't want to give this entire, you know, so many pages of the financial statement. You want to give a summary. So obviously, if I want to give a summary, I have to decide ke out of this audited financial statements, what part I want to retain in summary and what part I will say, oh, this is summary, so delete this. And no need to keep this part, right? So based on the audited, the summary will be prepared. And based on audited, obviously summary financial statements are derived from the audited financial statements. And now they are derived. And they are a derivative of the audited financial statements. But now this is the audited financial statements. From that, management has to prepare the summary financial statement. So they have to decide what to keep and what to delete. That means for summary financial statements, there will be an applied criteria. And you know, there is a mind-boggling definition of applied criteria. Management has to apply some criteria, na? Ke ye rakho, ye delete karo, na? When they are preparing summary financial statements out of the audited financial statements. And can you believe what is the definition of applied criteria? It can't come in your dreams also. What does it say? What is applied criteria? It is the criteria applied. Oh my God. What is applied criteria? It is the criteria applied by the management in preparing the summary financial statements. And the criteria applied. Right, by the management in preparing the summary financial statements. So first thing on earth, the moment I talk about SFS, summary financial statements, what two horns have to come out? First horn which has to come out is that it has to be the same uncle. And second, you also need to check now for the acceptability of the applied criteria. Very good. You understand, everyone? Yes? Okay. Now, for all these three standards, we have to discuss 3 points. And 800, 805, 810. For all these three standards, we need to discuss 3 points. 3 questions. And that's it. What are the 3 questions? Acceptance, planning, performing, reporting. Acceptance, planning, performing, reporting. Acceptance, planning, performing, reporting. That's what we need to discuss. Okay, what are the considerations for acceptance of this engagement? Then how do you plan and perform this particular engagement? And then what are the reporting requirements, right? So acceptance, planning, performing, reporting. Right. Everybody, all clear till here? Are you listening to me? Yes, all clear till here? Able to follow? You know, if you put water on a stone, does it stay or go inside the stone? No, it overflows. No, you put it on the stone and it will just overflow. But that same water, if I put it on the sponge, and will the sponge to its maximum capacity be able to absorb that water? Right. So I hope all the brains who are listening to this class are all spongy box and not rocks, rocky box sitting over there. Okay, how much ever you pour, it all just drains out. No, there has to be absorption. You understand? Okay. Right. So let's discuss this acceptance, planning, performing, reporting, and done. 3 standards done over there. Okay. Right. So now let's come to SA 800, right, which is regarding the special consideration audits of financial statements prepared in accordance with the special purpose framework, right? So you need to keep some material in front of you. So if it's the study material of ICAI, great. You know, because it's exactly in line with the study material of the ICAI. Okay, right. So special considerations, audits of financial statements prepared in accordance with the special purpose framework. What does it say? Acceptance, planning, performing, reporting. Hai na? Acceptance, planning, performing and reporting. And then they talk about what is the special purpose framework. It is for a specific set of users, right? If it is for a wide range of users, then it is a general purpose framework. If it is for a specific set of users, then it is a special purpose framework. And what are the examples of special purpose framework? So again, one candidate for question in your exam. And examples of special purpose framework. Okay, the cash receipts and disbursement details are being prepared at the request of the creditor. Financial statements have been prepared to meet the requirements of a regulator, or they have been prepared as per the requirement of a contract, as per a bond indenture, as per a loan agreement, or as per a project grant. That means for a specific set of users, when the financial statements are being prepared, that is the special purpose framework. Right? So first question which comes over there is the examples of the special purpose framework. Right. And now talking about the A. And we have to talk about APR. Do you agree? Acceptance, planning, performing and reporting. So now what we are talking about is the A. What is A? The acceptance of the engagement. What type of engagement are we talking about? We are talking about the special purpose framework. Special purpose framework, that means it is for a specific set of users. That means those specific set of users are my intended users. So you have to check what are the needs of the intended users. Okay, what these users require, you know, what, why they are preparing this financial statements. So first point which auditor needs to keep in mind while accepting an engagement for special purpose framework is who are going to be the intended users. Then, if, like, say if the financial statements are being prepared as per the US GAAP, you know, say they are being prepared to meet the requirements of a regulator, that means they are prepared as per the US GAAP, example. Or they are prepared to meet the requirement of a creditor. So now creditor is not given under any law regulation. And that creditor will say, okay, we want this particular detail, receipts and disbursement detail and so, okay, why we are not receiving the money from the company. So what does it say? This special purpose framework, it could be required by law. Right? It could be a requirement of the law or it may not be a requirement of the law, like example provisions of a contract, right? Other than those in the preceding paragraph. Right? So what is point number two? It could be as per the requirement of the law regulation, right? Or it may be other than the requirement of the law regulation, that is as per the provisions of a contract also. And whether that engagement, is it the correct engagement for the particular situation? Whether the engagement, is it acceptable or not? That AFRF, to determine that, it says it's a matter of the professional judgment for the auditor. Right, so what are the four points you need to consider while accepting the engagement? One, who are the intended users? Second, this framework that they are talking about, is it given under any law regulation or is it as per the provisions of any particular contract? And whether that framework is an acceptable framework as a special purpose framework also or not, for auditor to determine that, it says it's a matter of the professional judgment. Can institute ask this question in your exam? 100% yes. And can you write anything apart from these four points over there? 100% no. You say, ma'am, I mean the same thing. No. This is what is required to be written. Okay, who are the intended users? What are their need? Then the special purpose framework, is it as per any law or is it as per the provisions of any contract? And whether the AFRF, that's why I revised with you the preconditions. No, the acceptability of the AFRF. That's what we talked about. Right? The acceptability of the AFRF. So whether the AFRF, is it acceptable to the auditor as a special purpose framework? It says it's a matter of the professional judgment for the auditor. Okay, right. Then after that, we come to the planning and performing. So acceptance, done. Now talking about the planning and performing. Right? Though it is a special purpose framework, but it is coming in my SA ka series only. SA means it is standards on auditing. So though it is a special purpose framework, but that special purpose framework also what we are doing the audit only. Right? So even in this special purpose framework engagement, auditor, do you need to comply with the all SAs relevant to the audit? है ना. सो डू यू नीड टू इशू एंगेजमेंट लेटर, डू यू नीड टू कीप डॉक्यूमेंटेशन, डू यू नीड टू कंसिडर फ्रॉड, डू यू नीड टू कंसिडर लॉ रेगुलेशन, डू यू नीड टू यू नो कंसिडर द वर्क ऑफ सर्विस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, डू रिस्क असेसमेंट, चेक रिलेटेड पार्टी, comply with all essays relevant to the audit, unless that essay is not relevant. Okay, you know, 299, you're appointed as a sole auditor. So obviously 299 joint audit is not relevant. Or the requirement is conditional and the condition does not exist. That means, you know, company is not using the work of auditor, is not using the work of auditor's expert. Then obviously 620 will not apply. So it says comply with all essays. Then, if you're not able to comply with a particular essay, then you have to perform the alternative procedures. Even after performing the alternative procedures, you're not able to achieve the objective of that essay, you need to mention with the standards we could not comply. Right. Then, though it is the special purpose framework, do you need to have compliance with ethical requirements, including independence? Or will you say, "Arey, this is special purpose framework, no need of integrity, no need of objectivity"? No. Ethical requirements including independence? Yes. Right? So ethical requirements? Yes. All essays relevant to the audit. Don't comply with an essay when it is not relevant or it is conditional. And if you depart from the requirement of an essay, then what are the alternative audit procedures that you have performed? Okay, then now when I'm doing an audit of a special purpose framework, do I need to determine materiality? When I'm doing the audit of financial statements which management has prepared as per a special purpose framework, do I need to determine materiality? Yes, it says you have to determine materiality as per 320. But say the special purpose framework, listen to me, each and every word carefully. Special purpose framework is as per the provisions of a contract. Example, and the contract has given the threshold. Threshold is what? An alternative term for materiality. The contract has given the threshold, the materiality level to be 10 lakh. So now, should I determine materiality as per 320 or should I consider the materiality threshold which has been given in the special purpose framework? If no threshold is given in the framework, obviously I determine as per 320. But say it is given, the threshold of materiality has been given in the terms of the contract. Still, do I need to also comply with the requirement of 320? Yes. It says you determine, you consider the threshold which has been given in the special purpose framework, but that does not relieve the auditor from complying with the requirement of 320. So can it be that you only consider 320? Yes, but if there is a threshold, then you consider the threshold. But does that mean that you will now not consider 320? No, you will still consider 320. Right, so that's the question. Right, then after that, generally what we say, preparation, presentation of financial statements, it's, you know, the responsibility of the management with the oversight of TCWG. The special purpose framework, it is prepared for a creditor, it is prepared for a contract. It says TCWG may not have the oversight responsibility in case of the special purpose framework, right? So TCWG may not have the same oversight responsibility. And then you have to form your opinion as per SA 700. How many of you remember? I told you yesterday that forming an opinion is as? Forming an opinion is as? Is an art. Wow, super. Yes, AARRTT. You remember that? So it says form your opinion as per SA 700. Right? So these are the considerations while planning and performing. What does it say? Do you need to comply with all essays? Yes. Do you need to comply with ethical requirements? Yes. Do you need to determine materiality as per 320? Yes. If there is a threshold of materiality given in the special purpose framework, will you follow that? Yes. But will you also still comply with 320? Yes. Then TCWG, will they have oversight responsibility? It says they may not have. And how do you form your opinion? You form your opinion as per SA 700. Very good. Are you understanding this? Right? Planning and performing. And then we talk about the reporting. Right? So you will say prepared or they give a true and fair view and you express your opinion. But now in your audit report, you have to put a special paragraph. Why? Now, in your audit report, you will have to put a other matter or an emphasis of matter, a special paragraph in your report. Why? Because it is a special purpose framework. Right? So it says now in the audit report, the auditor will either report will describe the purpose and the intended users. Okay, why the special purpose financial statements are being prepared, for whom are they being prepared, or make a reference to the note where the management has mentioned the purpose and intended users. So, auditor, either you write it in your report, okay, the purpose and the intended users, or wherever management has written it in the financial statements, you make a reference to that note. And when management had a choice of AFRF, they had 10, 20 AFRF, out of that they selected this one as a special purpose framework. An explanation as to how the management decided that this is the right choice of the AFRF for them. And this is what the auditor needs to mention in his report. And the financial statements have been prepared by the management as per a special purpose framework for a particular purpose for a specific set of users. So that is why it says, auditor, you need to give an alert to the users that these financial statements are prepared as per a special purpose framework and they may not be suitable for another purpose. Right? So they are prepared only for the creditor, only for the banker. So they may not be suitable for another purpose. And where do you write this? That they are only for a specific user? It says you may write it in the report under the other matter paragraph. Right, under the other matter paragraph. Right, so let me just quickly come to one test your understanding question in essay 800. Right, so just give me a moment. Okay. Right, so CA Lalita, right, so all this is there in your study material also, is the auditor of a company. She is also offered professional work of audit of financial statement for meeting the requirements of a loan agreement. Okay, she chooses to accept the work and has made up her mind to disclose this fact in the other matter paragraph in it audit, in her audit report for this specific engagement. Is her approach proper? Right, the approach of Lalita is proper. There is no bar upon accepting an engagement, even though she is the auditor, because it can be the same or different auditor. She is intended to disclose this fact in the other matter paragraph to be issued for such specific engagement. And she is also going to put it in other matter. Right. Lakshmi has prepared a draft audit report for financial statements prepared as per the contract. She has drafted an unmodified opinion and now she wants to write in the report that the report should not be misused. Draft a suitable paragraph to be included in the report. Right. So I told you, you put a other matter paragraph. The heading can be basis of accounting and restriction on distribution and use. Without modifying our opinion, we draw attention to note A. You know, what if that special purpose framework has been given, which describes the basis of accounting. The financial statements are prepared to assist the management to comply with the financial reporting provisions of a contract referred to above. As a result, the financial statements may not be suitable for another purpose. Our report is intended solely for X Limited and Y Limited and should not be distributed to or used by parties other than X and Y. Right? So this is our raise to 10. Right? We expect this type of drafting question coming in your exam. And then after that, we have the question for the specific element account or item. Okay, right? Clear, everyone? Yes, all of you? One more standard done. Essay 800. So today for homework, what you will do? Essay 800. And then you will prepare a chart. What chart? Examples of the special purpose framework, acceptance, planning and performing and reporting. Like that. And then you prepare one particular chart for the 800 series.